said my house shall be a house of prayer for all people. Do I have a witness in the house? And then, watch this, he was able to heal. And then he was able to deliver. Do I have a witness in the house? Amen. He said, well, in essence, amen. Amen. I want you to know you got to clean up the temple. Somebody shout yes. I want you to know that here today, amen, we are the temple of God. Our bodies is the temple of the Holy Ghost. And the Bible went on, once he healed the people and they were delivered, here come some children singing, Hosanna, Hosanna to God. And they told Jesus, amen, they're irritating us. You need to do something about it. But Jesus, in essence, was telling them, y'all didn't give me no praise. You were doing the wrong thing. But I want you to know that I have ordained, I have perfected praise from babes. In other words, these babes, amen, they are praising me from the heart. Not like y'all. You are in the church house. You are selling and raising hell. But I want somebody to praise me with true praise. I want somebody to come from the heart. I want somebody to say praise the Lord and to come from the depths of their spirit. Somebody shout yes. Do you really love him? And if you praise him, you ought to be sanctified. You ought to have a heart as well as a mind. And I'm going to praise the Lord from the depths of my soul, from the bottom of my heart. I'm going to praise him because the Lord has done great things in my life. Somebody shout hallelujah up in there. My God is an awesome God. We sometimes are like, amen, the Pharisees. What am I talking about? Well, I want you to know something. We sometimes in life give him false praise because we're praising him for something he really didn't do. Now, what am I talking about? Well, the Lord gave me a few examples. And one of the examples was, amen, sometimes, whether it's male or female, I've known people to get up in church and praise the Lord for that man or that woman in their life. Now, ushers, don't let nobody out the door. Don't let nobody out the door. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord done blessed me with this man.
Yeah.
The Lord done blessed me with this woman.
Yeah.
And really it wasn't the Lord. It was lips, hips, and fingertips. It was biceps and it was triceps. And it was a smooth line. Oh yeah. And we are praising God. And God wasn't in it in the beginning. Because you didn't wait on God. Because you reminisce and you got it because you blinked a couple of two or three times and you, amen, did a few other things and when it doesn't work out, then you are blaming it on, amen, the devil. Well, I want you to understand you first gave God the glory and now you're saying the devil, you a liar. When in essence, we should have stuck with the word. Have you just know how can two walk together except they agree? Light and darkness will not have any fellowship. Somebody shout amen. There's sometimes people that say, well, the Lord bless me. Bless me with this job. Bless me what I have. And if you really look at it, you'll find out that some of them been scheming. Somebody been stepping over folk. Somebody been lying on somebody in order to get themselves in position. Because I want you to understand that if God do it, you can still be a Christian who can end up back of the line. Realizing that if you wait on the Lord and be of good courage, he will strengthen your heart. tonight, if God favors you, it doesn't matter what anybody else say. He will cause you to leap over somebody, but you don't have to step on nobody. You don't have to backbite. You don't have to criticize. You don't have to have a proud mentality. You can just learn how to wait on the Lord. Somebody shout, wait on the Lord.
You gotta wait on him.
You gotta wait on him. You don't do it yourself. That's what happens a lot of times. Even in life, we want to pull one another down because we want to make ourselves look good at the expense of somebody else. We don't pass a rumor. A half a lie is a whole lie. We don't get a little bit of amen, a little bit of sweet garbage on somebody, and then we got all we need to pull them down. But the devil is a lie. But I'm so happy that if anybody get a little garbage on me, God will vindicate me. Do I have a witness in the house? I don't have to worry about my reputation anyhow. I can just trust in the Lord. And if somebody got a bad word over you, I want you to understand, as the altar top say, a curse causeless will not prosper anyway. Because if I'm on the Lord's side, and if God be for me, he's more than those lies. He's more than all of that backbiting. He's more than all those rumors. He's more than anything that might come up against you. So you can go through the day smiling in the face of your enemies. And you don't have to, amen, put a dagger back in their back. You can just trust the Lord. And you can overcome evil with good. And you can bless them in the name of the Lord. Because you know that whatsoever man soweth, that shall they also reap. So you're going to reap your benefits because you sowed good seeds and leave the rest up to God. Somebody shout yes, Jesus. Wait on me and be of good courage. That sometimes folk want to praise God. Hell yeah. Amen. For the pain they have. In other words, I know some folk will praise God. And yes, you need to praise God and worship him at all times. But some people praise God for something bad happening to them. And God reminded me about even the physical. And God is saying, well, amen, it's some things that you overlooked. It's some things that I was trying to tell you. You should have corrected a long time ago. I reminded of an individual I was talking to just the other day. And the Lord, amen, there's some things happened. He fell over twice. And in different times. And he never went to the doctor. And then when he finally got there, it had messed up his kidneys to the point of no return. And I told him, I'm going to be praying for you, that God heal you. But God, amen, sometimes give us warning signs. And then sometimes we have the audacity to say, God, put this on me to teach me something. The devil is a lie. He was trying to teach you before you got into that situation. So you need to give God the glory for the warning signs. You need to give God the glory that he's speaking to your heart. Somebody shout yes. So therefore you got to be sensitive to the spirit, because God is trying to tell you something, because you're headed in the wrong direction. And when you get there, God, amen, is going to let you know that I was trying to keep you. I was trying to prevent you from going in that direction. So I want everybody up in here to realize that we serve a good God. We serve a loving God. We serve a kind God that wants us blessed. And so God is speaking to us so we won't get in a mess. He wants us blessed so we don't get in that mess. Somebody shout hallelujah. I've got the clothes here, but I want you to understand when that they said, give God the glory. This individual realized that there was something attached to that, because when they said, give God the glory, they went on to say, because this man is a sinner. Well, the man said, in the only light that he had received, whether he's a sinner or not, one thing I do know, that whereas I was blind, but now I can see. Anybody have that testimony today? But you can add more to that. die and on your way to hell. But the Lord, amen, gave light to your spirit. And whereas you were blind, now you can see in the spirit realm. I'm not so much concerned about the physical sight right now, but does anybody see from their spiritual eyes that you know that the Lord is awesome, and that you're going to give him all of the glory, that you're going to give him all of the praise? Somebody shout, yeah! I got to hurry up. Well, they kept saying, this man is a sinner. Well, they said, he has to be a sinner. But the man replied, in verse number 31, he said, now we know that God heareth not sinners, but if any man be a worshiper of God and doeth his will, him he heareth. In a general sense, God does not hear sinners, but he does hear a sinner's prayer of repentance. But in a general sense, God is not obligated to hear and answer sinners' prayers because they don't have a covenant with him. So this man says, well, this man can't really be a sinner because God only blesses those who worship the Lord. Do you get the message today? Do you worship the Lord? Are you giving him the glory? And if you worship him in spirit and in truth, God will hear you. God will answer you. God will bless your life. Somebody shout hallelujah. I'm closing now. I'm closing, but we find out that they went on and they kept being in the night because their choice was to reject the Christ, the one who came to save the lost. Amen. The one who came to save us from a burning hell. And so what they did, they did not listen to the man, but what they further did, well, they said, you must be one of his followers. So they booted him out of the synagogue. Yeah. Oh, but that's all right. Somebody need to give God the glory for the divine setup. Because as long as he just stayed in the midst of those religious nuts, he would have still been in the dark. But once they kicked him out, I want everybody to understand, when they kick you out of the clique, and when they, amen, they will reject you, you need to look at that as a good thing. Because sometimes you need to get by yourself where you be not influenced by those around you. And then you can listen to the Spirit of the living God. Because when you're around all your homies and all of your friends, amen, everybody got their opinion. But when you get to yourself, get by yourself and look to the Lord, God will begin to tell you something. Somebody shout yes. And when this individual was booted out of the synagogue, Jesus heard that he was kicked out of the synagogue, and he came to the man and he asked the man, do you believe in me? And the man says, let me know a little something that I can believe. And are you the Christ? Are you the one? And Jesus told him, yes, I am the one. And watch what the scripture says. The man believed on Jesus.